Martin Luther King once believed that each individual is an expression of divine worth and of dignity, which can only have meaning in terms of its relationship with others and communities of all races and of all cultures. The Young Inspiration Gospel Choir strives to express the moving energy that makes the gospel song an art. This energy was first brought to life among enslaved African Americans who took from it the strength and the assurance that someday they would live and that they would work in freedom. As a freedom song, the successful performance of gospel music requires the vocalist to sing with a selfless, unabashed discipline and strength that becomes the spirit of gospel music. It is this essence that distinguishes gospel music among other American musical arts. On behalf of the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir and our director, Silvester of Henderson, I would like to thank you for combining your thoughts with ours for this special gospel concert, which will radiate peace, joy, strength, but most of all, dignity. Thank you.
Thank you. Damon Brown.
And my name is Sheila Benezes.
And on behalf of the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir and our director, Professor Sylvester Carl Henderson, we would like to extend to you a warm welcome to our fall gospel extravaganza.
In 1985, five UC Berkeley students came together to fulfill a musical need on campus. And a year later, their gospel choir received Sylvester Henderson as official director. Since then, the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir has continued a commitment to excellence. Gospel music, developed in the Protestant churches in the South, endures as an intense and joyful music. It is an essential and viable art form, and for many, a spiritual celebration. It has been Dr. Henderson's mission and dream to introduce gospel music into the academic institutions, like it is now instituted at Berkeley. We would like to thank you for being here and for your continued support of us as a gospel choir and of Dr. Henderson's effort. For those of you who have never heard gospel and never seen it live, we hope this evening we will powerfully present gospel as celebration, as exemplary art, as an integral part of American culture. And for those of you familiar with gospel, we hope this evening will be a milestone.
In the afterglow of the success of our last album, we have been availed numerous opportunities to bring gospel music to places where it might have never been heard before. We are very enthusiastic about this because, as a whole, we believe in the music that we sing. To us, our songs are more than just words, and it is our goal to witness in song to everyone. Gospel music transcends color lines, age, and ethnic barriers. It brings people of all backgrounds and beliefs together, as you can see just by looking at the diversity of its members. At a time when so many other things in society are working to pull us apart and destroy the bliss of diversity, we are fortunate to have an aesthetic such as gospel music that has such a cohesive character. So this evening, we invite you as active participants to sit back and relax, jump up and shout, laugh, cry, do anything that your spirit moves you to do. It is our prayer that everyone in this building receives some blessing tonight.
We welcome all of you to join us in the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir experience.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. You know what? I am once again very excited about the fact, especially for this performance here, because it's a blessing from God, as well as you yourself, the audience, is a blessing to us. That we are almost going into our 15th year of existence, and this program basically started from just an idea, and look what the Lord has done for us. Many of you attended our program that we had this year, which was our second Gospel Experience live recording, and we tried to make a promise to you, and we were fortunate to be able to keep that promise. And the promise that we made was that our second recording is available for your purchase. So if you want to take the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir home with you, we have it available for you. You don't have to be lonely. It's $12. And this CD really is, I am very proud of it, because not only of the artwork that went into it, but all the time, but it really is a beautiful recording. We would encourage many of you to continue to support us by purchasing one of our recordings, because I've just received so many calls of individuals asking when it was going to be ready, and we worked hard to get it out for this event. So we hope those of you who have enjoyed it, you will tell someone else about it. And we also have, if you notice at the bottom of the program, we were originally scheduled to have both our cassettes and CDs here. The CDs did not arrive. We did not order as many CDs this time, but if you would like, there is an address form inside, an order form. You can fill it out and mail it to the address, and we'll be glad to send you a CD back within a couple of weeks. But in any regard, we do have the tapes available. We also have a sale going on. We talked about our last performance, we had a sale. That's our first tape. We made our first tape back in 92, and you know what? That tape still sounds good to me, and I know it's going to sound good to you. And you know what? Now that sale is only, we're selling those cassettes for $10, and we're selling these for $12. So we're just hoping that many of you will purchase those recordings to help us to continue. So now I've given my introduction, but you look beautiful. Give yourself a hand clap for it. We have had a tradition here, and it's the same tradition, one of the selections on our recording, Total Praise. We're going to open our program up with Total Praise, which is a wonderful selection composed by the world-renowned Richard Smallwood. And I'm going to combine this selection with another college gospel choir that I was fortunate to start from Los Medanos College. So I'm going to ask that Brother Jonathan give us some organ music as we bring this other group up to sing Total Praise along with it. Give him a hand clap, please.
Thank you. Thank you.
in the Rock of Ages.
Thank you. Now, while y'all clapping, you can take that home with you. Y'all can just keep on clapping all during the year. See, the youngest generation gospel choir really loves you. We love you a lot. That's why we made you a friend. We have a young man who's very dear to my heart. You know what? I'm going to ask that you sort of move close, because we actually sold out of every single ticket in terms of the capacity, and there are some people that are standing. There's a couple of seats over here you may want to fill into. Some of you that are standing over there if you would like. And are there any seats in the balcony? If there's a couple of seats in the balcony, I would welcome many of you to kind of fill in. There's a couple, maybe two or three seats over here. Some of you may want to make yourself over so that you don't have to stand for the evening. Because one thing usually a lot of times you go to gospel conferences, they don't start on time. But Brother Henderson always starts on time. Well, sometimes, you know, people come in talking about it's CP time. We always know it's YIGC time at 6. All right. We're going to have a young man by the name of Brother Titus Starks to come at this point and sing a sort of a Popeye's arrangement of the African-American spiritual, I Want Jesus to Walk With Me.
Thank you. Doesn't Tyler have a beautiful voice on? Give him another hand clap for him. Now, Brother Titus want to be your friend. Brother Titus is on here. He wants, don't y'all want Titus to be your friend? Y'all give Titus another hand clap for me. I must request that we are so overpacked in here that if there is there's an extra seat over here, if there's a seat, because there's some people that are standing in the back who have actually paid tickets and they may have been running a little late. Could you raise your hand and see where you're at so people can sort of fill in? Those of you who see the hand raised, if you would, from the walls, have a seat for me if you would like, please. Feel free. There's some seats over here. There's some in the middle there and some other ones as well. And there's also some people in the back. Preston, find some of the people for me. The hands are raised and they can find some spots to be seated. We would like everyone to have a seat if at all possible. And we had also said that there are some individuals that if they still wanted to come, we could allow them to come, but they would have to stand, but I want to make sure that all the seats are taken first, okay? God bless. You know what, this is really a beautiful thing for us because 15 years ago, I used to go around begging folks to come. I would buy all the tickets and give them away free myself. So you know what, this is a beautiful sight. Our next selection, Heaven Belongs to You. Very rarely do you find alto duets and gospel music. And these two young ladies got together and created a beautiful duet to this song, Sonia Lindsay and Gina Brady. Give them a hand clap.
Thank you.
You can take them home too.
See, you know what? We try to express love, a lot of love for you. Next selection, I Surrender All, is going to be directed by Shireen Buchanan. Thank you.
You can take that home with you too. Right on here. Side number two. Third song. You don't have to be lonely. All right. You know what? I am so fortunate to have had an opportunity to work with so many young people, and that is really a great joy of mine. Probably one of my greatest joys in life is to teach music and to mold. I get a greater enjoyment in teaching others how to do, even if I myself don't do. Because that really is the art of being a teacher, to find enjoyment not in what you do, but find enjoyment in what other people are doing. And I am so fortunate for another post that I actually hold as the director of choral activity at Los Padanos College. There are two young ladies that are part of my a cappella choir. We do a lot of traditional classical sort of things. And these two young ladies have our fabulous soloists, and they've won many state competitions around singing, and they are there to do it from Sister Act 2, His Eyes on the Sparrow. And we're going to ask that they come at this point to sing Amber Connell and Tara Sim.
He watches me.
Wright and Corey Jones come at this time, please?
Conducted by their nationally acclaimed director, Sylvester Carl Henderson, the Los Medanos College Gospel Choir was formed in the spring semester of 1995.
Since then, they have earned a reputation as one of the finest community college gospel choirs in the state of California. Each year, during the month of May, the choir produces a grand-scale community event called the Gospel Celebration.
This event has become Los Medanos College's largest community-based event. During May of 1998, the Gospel Celebration attracted over 1,200 persons. These celebrations have brought many local and nationally noted gospel artists to campus, such as Kirk Carr and the Kirk Carr Singers,
Lawrence Matthews,
the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir,
Helen Stevens and the Lighthouse Singers,
and most recently, Eddie Baltrip and the Voices of Fulfillment from San Diego, California.
Ladies and gentlemen,
we proudly present to you the Los Medanos College Choir.
I am very pleased to have this ensemble. We are now, as stated, we started back, I believe it was the spring semester of 95, and they have been so fortunate. The last program that they sponsored last May, they were able to attract over 1,200 persons from the Pittsburgh area. And this is another tradition. We call that tradition out in that area the Gospel Celebration. At the tradition at UC Berkeley is called the Gospel Experience. So I want you once again to welcome the Los Medanos College Gospel Choir for me. Give them another hand. Our first selection is a selection that's sort of like an anthem. It's entitled Spirit of God, composed by Leonard Burks, who's a composer who does a lot of arranging and writing for Margaret Duro.
Thank you. In time, he'll bring you out.
Hey!
Frank, the solo mics, we need to keep these solo mics up if we could, please. God bless. Y'all give Brother Frank a hand clap for me. We're going to ask at this time that we have Aaron Connor and Malcolm Darrell come to present our special guest from Natchitoches, Louisiana. Now, it took me a long time to say Natchitoches. I like saying Natchitoches, Louisiana. All right.
Good evening. I'm Aaron Connor.
My name is Malcolm Darrell.
It is our pleasure to introduce to you Micah Stampley.
God called Micah to the ministry of music at the young age of 9 years old. He has labored as a director and a lead vocalist ever since. Born in the capital city of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Micah now resides in Natchitoches, Louisiana.
Micah's calling has been a blessing to the ministries of Pasadena Youth Outreach Ministries and John P. Key and the New Life Community Choir. He has ministered the gospel of Jesus Christ through song in countries such as London, England, Russia, South Africa, and many others. God has given Micah favor as he has shared stages with many gospel artists such as Daryl Coley, Yolanda Adams, Vanessa Bell Armstrong, and the Reverend James Moore. He was featured as a guest director with the Reverend John P. Key and the Victory in Praise Seminar Mass Choir album entitled Stand.
God has recently opened a door for Micah on a project with Pastor Levi King and Restoration Choir of St. Louis. The album is entitled Breathe On Me, featuring him and Kim Burrell as special guest vocalist. Micah has chosen to work for God unconditionally and diligently. Many lives have been delivered and restored through his anointed and appointed ministry. Prepare to receive and be blessed by the profound ministry of Micah Stampley.
Now, I want y'all to clap better than that. Y'all give that man a better clap than that. Thank you.
Cherubim and Just ain't never had a bill due, and you didn't know where you was gonna get the money from? Did your light stay on? Did you end up with food on your table? Did you end up with clothes on your back? You know what? Hey! You did!
Yeah!
I had an opportunity to hear Mr. Stampley last year down at a program that Jonathan was involved in with the ministry that he starts along with his family in Pasadena. And out of all the, you know, I'm not a pretentious fella. You know, within gospel music, unfortunately, there's a whole lot of people that does a lot of singing. But a lot of those folks do a lot of singing and don't live by what they're singing. And so, you know what, I generally don't look at what people sing. I look at how they act when they're around their friends. That tells who they are, not what they sing. And so when I heard this young man, one of the things I told the class last night, we've had gospel artists to come from all over the world here at this campus. We've had some of the finest talent to come. And I don't invite no one unless I feel that they have an humble spirit. And I would like to just give a public acknowledgement to him as demonstrating that humility through his music. Give him another hand clap for me, please. Now, this is always something that I try to rush, but you know what? I'm not going to rush this. And I'm going to tell you the reason why is because many of you are enjoying yourself, but for almost 15 years, and most people will enjoy themselves with this program. Brother Henderson here have been dedicating this part of his life to this program. I have lost many hours of sleep and gone through many, many problems. I've gone through lawsuits. I've gone through people writing me bad letters. I've gone through just people not being supportive. But you know what? I was very determined that I held a dream, that I felt that gospel music was very important for the system. The system did not always support Brother Henderson and this program. And so I am so thankful. Now the system is beginning and starting to support. But what has happened over the years is that there have been students who have always stood beside myself to help continue the dream of promoting African-American religious music in the institution, because African-American music really is the forefront and forefather of all the American popular styles. And so there are some students that I must take. There are some students that I must take the time to acknowledge. And I'm going to get my notes out, because I'm going to ask first my student musical director, Mr. Jonathan DeCue, to come forward. You know what, I don't have to tell Jonathan that I think he's special, because Jonathan knows that if I didn't think he's special, he wouldn't be playing the piano. Jonathan plays for me all around, not only for UC Berkeley, but he plays for me where I'm a minister of music at a huge church in Hayward whenever we have a special program. And I am just so thankful that the Lord has graced him. He was with us alone when I had my first student director, Miss Idella Watts, who's now completing and culminating her PhD on gospel music in Philadelphia. And every year what I do is that I always stay in prayer and ask the Lord somehow to send me another young person that I can encourage to grow and help build their skill. And at the time my daughter was leaving, the Lord sent us Jonathan. And when Jonathan was leaving, the Lord sent us Shireen. And so, you know, it's just a tradition. And so this is a plaque. It's a pen so that Jonathan can simply set on his desk that says many things. Jonathan McCure, youngest rich in gospel choir, because he knows that Miss Henderson loves him dearly. Give him a hand clap for him. I would like to also ask that our student musical assistant, Ms. Shireen Buchanan, come forward, please.
Shireen is a young lady who, Shireen will be, I believe, culminating her Bachelor of Arts degree in ethnomusicology with an emphasis in gospel music. You know, that is so unique because I was the first person in California to actually do that years ago. And you know, when I was actually doing it, all the professors told me, boy, you're silly. You can't do anything with gospel music. But look at the Lord. Look at what he's done. And so this is just, once again, you know, I'm a lover of things that you can see to remember people by who love you. And I am so thankful once again for Shireen being not only just a talent for this ensemble, but a talent to herself. Because, you know, you need to be a blessing to yourself. Because many times when other people are putting you down, you need to like yourself. Because when you try to make something not yourself, trust me, there's going to be a whole lot of people who are going to tell you ain't worth nothing. So don't let those folks, if somebody telling you that, you tell them, Satan loose there. But you know what? I really want to thank Shireen just for having just a wonderful spirit. And this is just a plaque I got on for her for just her work with us this semester. She works as our student musical assistant director here for the choir. So stand and give her a hand clap for me, please. I would like to ask Sonia Lindsay, Cameron Green, and Michelle Skinner to come forth, please. These are three of the managers for the choir. Sonia has been our longest manager. Sonia, raise your hand for me. And Cameron Green, who takes care of our mailing list. We have quite a few people on our mailing list, and we would also like to add many of you, if you are not on our mailing list, the Youngest of Rich and Gospel Choir want to let you know about all of our events that are coming up, as we'll be back here in this church on April the 24th in 1999, celebrating our next gospel experience celebration. And Michelle Skinner, that beautiful program that you have in front of you, this is the young lady right here who's responsible for that. Michelle and Sonia both are graduating this semester, but you know, when people come to the Youngest of Rich and Gospel Choir, I tell them, you know, you're a member for life. They come and they leave, but they always come back. You know, there's so many students that always come back, and we celebrated back a couple of years ago our 10th year reunion and had over 300 students that came back from all over the state of California and even out of California. And that was just a glorious time. And so this is just, once again, just three tokens that I got on behalf of the choir to let these three young ladies know how much we love them and appreciate all the work they've given to the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir. Give them a hand clap for them. We would like to ask Candace Burrell, Melissa Burrell, Annie Lee, Vivian McBride, Stephanie Smith, and Letitia Wright to come forth, please. This is our coordinating committee that sort of worked along with encouraging some of the guidelines that I would like to see in terms of our discipline and structure. These young ladies, along with some other people, were responsible for how the choir looks. I think the choir looked beautiful. You know, I think they sound good and look good too. And they were responsible for taking care of many of just the logistics for the choir. And so this is just a certificate to let them know how much we appreciate them for their commitment once again to the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir. Give them a hand clap, please. Now every year, we have kind of like a race to see who is the highest ticket seller. Because you know, I tell the choir that this is not the sort of choir that you can come in and come to rehearsal and don't be a part of anything. I've told the students before we were a class, you're gonna sell tickets. I used to tell the students, if you don't sell the tickets, that's fine, you owe me $100. And we have some students sitting right here in the front who can testify. I told them, you know what, it's easy to sell a ticket. Someone walking down the street say, we got a concert, please come. If they say no, there's somebody gonna come. If you keep asking, somebody gonna come. And so every year, I give awards to the highest ticket sales. So I brought along my roster this time so that I could see who turned in the most money. And so far, we would like to acknowledge both Letitia Wright and Gina Braden. Letitia turned in
Letitia turned in $326 to the Younger Serration Gospel Choir, and Gina turned in $322. So give them a hand clap for them. I would like to ask that the individual on the podium will give another hand clap if they take their seats for me, please. I would like to give a special acknowledgement to our special guest, Mr. Micah Stampley. We're so appreciative for him joining our great list of great talent coming to this campus. We would like to acknowledge his presence again. I would also like to acknowledge, if Mr. Stampley would stand, please. I would also like to acknowledge our musicians, Calvin Brown, our bass player, Omar Maxwell, our drummer. And we have a new young man. Y'all give him a hand clap. And you know there's a, I always like to surprise people. Sometimes it's not always pleasant, but I try. There's a new young man who is the organist for my church, which is the Palmacia Baptist Church in Hayward. And I was debating as to who I would ask to play, and he's a fine organist. And I am so thankful that this year we added him to our staff, and that is Mr. Eric White. Give him a hand clap. Thank you. I would also like to thank Dr. Percy Henson, Chair of the African American Studies, Francis Carter, and Stephanie Jackson, who is our office administrators. You know what, I need to say that because a lot of times, you know, people are around, and sometimes I'm always calling, asking them to do check requests and things, and sometimes when you ask people to do things a lot, they forget. We forget sometimes to acknowledge them, so I want to thank them for their work. I would like to, where's Mark Stanfield? Is Mark present? Mark Stanfield? The young man, I would just acknowledge him. Those of you who would see the beautiful design of our album, I think our album design, which is made in the pattern of our vest for the choir, was designed by a gentleman by the name of Mark Stanfield. I want to thank the time to acknowledge him. I want to also thank the time to acknowledge Universal Duplications for taking care of our cassettes for us. We would like to also thank many of our community supporters, Ms. Freddie Davis from the NAACP, Dr. Charles Upshaw, who is our campus administrator. And I would also like to thank the Los Madonnas Gospel Choir for coming and singing here at UC Berkeley. Y'all give them a hand clap for me. Now, I always take the time to acknowledge my mother. Mama, stand up. Y'all go give Mama those flowers for me. Because you know, without Mama, I wouldn't have been here. And if I wouldn't have been here, this wouldn't have been here. So y'all give Mama another hand clap for me. I would also like to thank my wife for having not left me yet, you know. You know, it is very difficult, I say every year, I know it's very difficult because I do probably have too many choirs. I have so many choirs, it's pitiful. You know, and sometimes my wife says that, you know, I love this. She said, I'm the only man who's having an affair with the youngest raging gospel choir. But you know what, I really want to thank my wife for being a wonderful support. She's a beautiful woman too. And we bought these roses just to let her know how much we love her for not leaving me yet. Y'all give her a hand clap for me. You still stand up. Now y'all, you know what y'all tell her? Y'all tell her, don't leave her. When I get home at 1 o'clock in the morning for rehearsal, she said, you ain't been, I said, I've been in rehearsal with that money. So I want to thank my wife. I would also like to acknowledge my children. There's two young ladies in the front. One semester, my daughter got mad because I didn't call her name. Now she don't want me to tell her, but I got to tell her. But you know what, I would just like to acknowledge my three daughters. They have two in the front, and then my youngest daughter is right in the front. Sade, stand up. We would also like to acknowledge my mother-in-law, Mrs. Dupre. Where's my mother-in-law? I know she has Nana. Stand up. Nana's waving. Y'all give Nana a hand clap for me. You know, I like to acknowledge these persons because there were many, many, many years when driving home alone, I was extremely frustrated for having a dream, and it just seemed as though it just was not going anywhere.
And so these are individuals who were in my life that was always giving me encouragement to continue. And so I want to thank them. I would also like to thank all of the ex-members of the Youngest Enriching Gospel Choir. We have one of our ex-members who sings this occasionally, Malcolm in the front. And we also have Cherie Wooten, who drove all the way up from Los Angeles here for the concert. I want to ask them to stand. Give them a hand clap. Now, y'all talking about a young lady that can sing. Cherie can sing. Now, if you want to hear Sister Cherie, she's out there on that tape. Sister Cherie want to be your friend. She's one of the music directors at the prominent West Angeles Church of God in Christ down in Los Angeles. Are there any other ex-members of the choir here? If you are, please stand. Oh, in the back. Two gentlemen in the back, both Daniel Van Harley and Preston Taylor. I would also like to give them a handcuff, please. We would also like to thank all the parents and relatives of the choir. I'm going to ask that you stand, please, and ask the choir to give you a hand clap. If you are a parent or a relative of anybody in the choir, stand at this time, please. Y'all give them a hand clap. Come on. Come on. Keep on.
We would also like to ask all of our graduating seniors to please stand. I would like to once again give a special thanks to Ms. Latrina Savage. Latrina is one of our alumni persons that just has a young lady with a sweet spirit. She served as a manager for many years, and she always comes back to either sing with us or help with the door. She calls me around the time of the concert and always asks if there's anything she could do. So I want to acknowledge Latrina Savage again for all of her support. I would like to also once again acknowledge Mr. Tyler Starks for continuing to support us. We have just a couple, then we're going to get back to our music. See, I keep a big clock because I'm a timely man, and I carry that clock with me everywhere I go. I keep that clock right there. It kind of keeps me on schedule. In rehearsal, I look at that clock. At church, I put that clock. Everywhere I go, I got my clock. And I would like to also thank Mr. Frank Hopkins. Frank, we have been using this wonderful, isn't this a beautiful church? We've been using this church for over 10 years now. And the sound engineer of this church, who has become just a longtime friend of mine, and he's always very cooperative and supportive, and that's the sound engineer, Mr. Frank Hopkins. We want to thank him as well for all of his support. We would like to also thank the First Presbyterian Church for the use of their building, and I have a special award. There was a person, you know what, I am so thankful to the Lord, not only for the motivation of the choir members and all of you for your support. There's a special young lady that I know, and that every year, you know what, she doesn't know how much this means to me. Not only does the choir sell 30 and 40 tickets, but this young lady, I would like to name as our Young Inspiration Gospel Choir Community Supporter. Because she always sells 30, 40, 50 tickets for us and doesn't say anything about it. And that's Mrs. Etten McKinley. We want to ask Mrs. Etten McKinley if she'll come forward for you. Y'all give her a hand clap. This is just a plaque that I got for Edna to let her know. Now, there's other people that sell tickets, but you know, Edna is very special because every semester, she writes out a check for $200, $300, whatever the cost of the tickets are, and she always calls back, and whatever we need, she's always right there. And so she works as, an administrator for, the city office in Martinez. And so we're so thankful for her, and I want her, when she look at this plaque, to remember this evening and let her know that we really thank her for all of her support to the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir. I would also like to thank the gentlemen who are ushering for us in the back, the fraternity, Kappa Alpha Phi, who's taking care of all of our ushers, and everyone else. If we've missed anyone, if I said the name wrong, y'all know what I'm saying. If I said the name wrong, just the folks in the back, we thank them. We would like to also thank you, the audience. And go to the key of F major for me, please. There's a special friend of mine that has a birthday. His name is Arthur Simmons, and he always supports us. And I want you to sing happy birthday to him for me. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Come on, Arthur. Come on. Give him a hand clap for me. Happy birthday. If we have missed anyone, it has not been my intention. I am a gracious man who always tell the choir, I believe in people doing things with dignity in class. I have always believed that. I don't like a lot of folks doing things slouchy without dignity in class. So if I have missed anyone in terms of thanking you for your support, it has not been our intention. I should acknowledge the Department of Music for the usage of their facilities on the campus because we are officially part of the Department of African American Studies and we have an affiliate relationship with the music department. We are an official class and would like to invite any UC Berkeley students who would love to commit and would love to work because we, as we did this semester, we are planning to go on tour again this coming semester. We're going to be singing hopefully at Hollywood High School. So we're going down to Hollywood High. And so I am thankful for what's coming up next semester. And once again, if we missed anybody, it is not our intention. We love all of you and thank you for your support. So before we actually start our music selection again, I'm going to simply ask that the choir stand and give you, the audience, a hand clap, please.
Good evening. We have missed someone, and I would like to take this time on behalf of myself, my co-chairs, the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir, and many of you. Mr. Henderson is a man who proves to be dedicated to his dream, to his heart, to the Lord, and he works very, very, very hard at it. I cannot say that I know too many people that work as hard as he does for such a wonderful purpose. And for me to have been able to be a part of it for 5 years, I've grown since my first year here at Cal. As a young lady, as a student, as a singer, as an individual, as a study under Mr. Sylvester Henderson. And we want to take this time to recognize his effort, his sacrifices, his family sacrifices, his time, his love, his spirit, his honesty, his dedication, everything that makes up what Sylvester is to myself and us as a group. So we would like to present, on behalf of the choir, we took up a collection as a group to support this. As long as I've been here, I cannot remember in a time where we recognize Mr. Henderson in this manner. So we wanted to make it special. And we would like to present to Mr. Henderson and his wife a gift certificate to the Claremont Resort and Spa. Happy anniversary. We love you. We love you. Thank you. We'd also like to recognize his three lovely daughters, these young ladies who have also supported us, who have gone on our road trips with us, who have been here at our concerts, who sacrificed the time spending with their father. And we appreciate you all giving us this man, who also disciplines us as his children. But we'd like to present to you these flowers on behalf of the Young Inspiration Gospel Choir. We appreciate it so much, so much. And to his daughters, we're going to call their names. This is Sade. The middle child is Salise. Am I right?
That's right.
And the oldest child is Carlena. Thank you so much. If you can, you come here.
That was truly a surprise, and you know what? That will mean, that means a lot both to my family as well as my wife and I, because on this Friday, we will be celebrating our 16th year anniversary. So we didn't know where we were going, but now we know. Thank you. I love you. God bless. Thank you. We would like to now go to our next part of the program. That was a selection written by our student musical assistant. That's a dynamite selection, entitled "I Want to Be Ready," Ms. Shireen Buchanan, and the soloist is Ms. April Smith.
Hey, April. I love to take all the credit because this little thing called honesty, that we kind of, it's a policy. But the music was also written by Mr. Jonathan DeCure himself. And also Cameron Green, who was just down here, helped me with part of the chorus. So thank you guys. Thank you, Sylvester, for everything. Our soloist is Sister April.
Thank you.
Make me out of here. Make me out of here. Once again, directed by Shireen Buchanan, the soloist, Melissa Berrio, and what is Mr. Guy Howard. Melissa Berrio. This selection, which is also found on our CD, that wants to, an album that wants to be your friend. We want to be your friend. Now, you got to help us be your friend for $12. They run out in the front. This selection was also written by Mr. Jonathan DeCure. Give him a hand clap, please.
Just maybe I'll be
This year we sponsored in class what we called our special. We had what sort of like a gong show. We, you know, there was a lot of students. Normally, sometimes I audition everybody, but sometimes, you know, there's hidden soloists that we don't hear. And so this year we did special auditions for a person to become. I told them about 2 weeks in advance. Now you're always complaining that I don't give you an opportunity because, you know, people don't always, everything that looks good ain't always good. So, you know, I walk down the hall with a student and say, he don't never let me say. But you know what, this, I was really thankful that we were able to do some auditions and I heard some beautiful talent. But out of all the talent, we had a special featured young lady that's gonna come and be our YIGC featured soloist for the evening. And her name is Cameron Green. Give her a hand.
Thank you.
Wasn't that a beautiful vocalist? Give her another hand clap for me. I'm a man that generally likes a 2.5 hour program. I'm looking at my clock. We had 2 selections planned, but we are going to cut that down to 1. Because you know what? I just think that everything should be done decently in order. And a 2.5 hour program is a long enough program. You've been a wonderful audience, but you know.